Hi, this is Kashpunisa Bagewadi. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to talk about AWS weekly release for the week of 21st September 2020. So let's start. AWS CloudFormation now supports StackSets resource type in the CloudFormation registry. Amazon MSK managed streaming for Apache Kafka now support SASL SCRM authentication with username and passwords secured by AWS Secrets Manager. Amazon Aurora PostgreSQL patches 2.5.4, 2.6.1, 3.2.4, 3.3.1 now generally available. Amazon Aurora PostgreSQL supports PG Logical extension. Amazon Aurora increased maximum storage size to 128 TB. Amazon RDS for PostgreSQL supports new minor versions 12.4, 11.9, 10.14, 9.6.19 and 9.5.23. Amazon RDS M6G and R6G instance types powered by AWS Graviton 2 processors in preview and now supported on more database versions. Amazon Redshift Spectrum as support for querying open source Apache Hudi and Delta Lake. Amazon Comprehend now supports Amazon SageMaker ground truth training datasets for custom model training. Amazon AppStream 2.0 releases self-guided workshop to deploy the end user computing dashboard. Amazon Workspaces releases self-guided workshop to deploy the end-user computing dashboard. Now available AWS SSO credentials profile support in AWS Toolkit for JetBrains IDEs. Amazon Lex now offers language support for US Spanish. Amazon DocumentDB adds the dollar out aggregation stage and increases the maximum number of connections and cursors. You now can restore Amazon DynamoDB table backups as new tables in the Africa, Cape Town, Asia Pacific, Hong Kong, Europe, Milan, and Middle East, Bahrain regions. Announcing new CloudWatch metrics for capacity monitoring on AWS Outpost. Amazon CloudWatch Synthetic Strengths End-to-End Canary Run Debugging with X-ray Traces. AWS Backups now support application-consistent backups of Microsoft workload running on EC2 via Microsoft Volume Shadow Copy Services. Announcing AWS Glue Studio, Visual Job Authoring and Advanced Monitoring for AWS Glue. AWS Security Hub adds 14 new controls to AWS Foundational Security Best Practices Standard. You can now view all Amazon EC2 instances across all your accounts that are non-compliant with your configured patch rules in a single dashboard via AWS Security Hub. Amazon Elasticsearch service now offers T3 instances. You can queue purchases of savings plan by specifying a time of your choosing in the future to execute those purchases. Announcing event logging and self-upgrade capabilities in SSM agent with new version 3.0. Announcing the general availability of Amazon Koreto 15. Amazon Transcribe as support for AMR, OGG, and WebM file formats. Amazon Connect decreases outbound telephony rates for the second time this year in Europe. Amazon TextTrack has improved accuracy for detecting currency symbols, key value pairs, and checkboxes. Introducing AWS Cost Anomaly Detection in preview mode. AWS Copilot CLI launches version 0.4 focused on auto-scaling and operations. AWS Launch Wizard now supports SAP deployments with Red Hat Enterprise Linux version 8.1. AWS Fargate increases default resource count service quotas. Introducing AWS Perspective. AWS Perspective is a new AWS solution implementation that helps you build detailed architecture diagram of your workloads from live data in your account that you can customize and share. Announcing the availability of three new AWS Wavelength Zones on Verizon's 5G Ultra Wideband Network in Atlanta, New York City, and Washington, D.C. Amazon EC2 C5A instances now available in South America, Sao Paulo region. Amazon EC2 INF1 instances based on AWS Infinitia now available in Europe, Paris, Asia Pacific, Mumbai, Singapore, and South America, Sao Paulo regions. AWS Ground Station is now available in Africa, Cape Town region. Usability improvement for AWS Management Console in navigation header and footer now available. AWS Lake Formation is now available in Europe, Milan region. Amazon ECS is now available in Los Angeles AWS local zones. Amazon Elastic Cache is now available in AWS local zones in Los Angeles. Now it's even easier to connect JetBrains IDEs to Amazon RDS or Redshift databases. That's it for this week. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.